नमो महाबुदन्याय कृष्णो प्रेम प्रदायति कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामिने गोविंदसेन हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधो गोपेश गोपिका तंत्र राधाकांचन गौरंगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणामे हरिप्रिये वृंदे नमस्ते चरणारविंदम् श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवाचारी गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम राम हरे हरे। आज एक विशेष तिथि सुबह वैष्णव सात प्रभु श्रील जगन्नाथ दास बाबा जी महाराज का तिरुभाव तिथि, दूसरी आज रसिकानंद देव गोस्वामी महाराज का तिरुभाव तिथि, तदुपरि हमारा गुरुपाद पद्म नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट ओम विष्णुपाद शिष्यमान भक्ति माधव गोस्वामी महाराज का उनका भी तिरुभाव तिथि। सुबह कुछ बोला था और बहुत सारा गीत बाकी, तो इसमें से ये हमारा एक पन्ना है। उनका महिमा कीर्तन ना करना एक अपराध है, इसलिए ये करना जरूरी है। जगन्नाथ दास बाबा जी को बारे में इन्होंने अनुवाद में भी बताया ये कैसे नवद्वीप धाम को मायापुर को आविष्कार किया, लेकिन विस्तृत तो नहीं बोला, थोड़ा बोला उन्होंने। वो दूर माफ करके ये निर्णय के शिवासंगन माटी खुदाई किया तो मृदंग का चौड़ा मिला, जहाँ चांद काजी मृदंग फोड़ा था। ये महापुरुष इनका ये है दिव्य नेत्र, दिव्य नेत्रों में ये लोग क्या करते हैं, दिव्य नेत्रों में वो धाम को देखते हैं, दिव्य नेत्र में धाम को दिखते हैं। इसलिए बोलता है धामेर स्वरूप स्फूरी वे नयन है, तो देखेंगे ऐसा सब एक उन्होंने एक बात बोला। उनको यहाँ से टोकरी में ले जाके वृंदावन, वृंदावन से नवद्वीप, तो वहाँ जब वृंदावन में था उनका सेवक नाम था बिहारी दास बाबा जी, तो रात्रि में कीर्तन सुनते थे शानदार आवाज, तो उनका वही कीर्तन सुनने के लिए रुचि हुआ। बाबा जी महाराज से प्रार्थना करते थे आप आज्ञा करने से मैं वहाँ कीर्तन सुन के आ जाऊँ, उन्होंने क्या बोला, उन्होंने बोला अभी नहीं जाना, जाने बार बार प्रार्थना करने से बोला भय भी तो होगा नहीं तो, बोले भय किस बात की, आप रक्षक है हमारे भाई की, बात बोले जाओ लेकिन प्रसाद नहीं करना, यहां दे करके मुझको देना। खूब सुंदर कीर्तन किया, कीर्तन समाप्त हुआ उसके बाद प्रसाद दिया, तो उसमें जो प्रसाद दिया उसमें क्या है, एक नाखून और एक बाहुल ए उनमें दिया। तो बोला खोल प्रसाद दे हमको, तो बोला और जाए, बोलती जाओ गए, बोले जाएंगे भाई भी तो होगा नहीं तो, भाई किस बात की। जब तीन दिन हुआ तब उन्होंने वही जो लोग कीर्तन करते थे ये बोला बाबा जी महाराज का माध्यम से हम लोग क्या सेवा करो जिससे हमारा उद्धार हो, हम लोग देवस्त्र अपहरण किया, ये देवस्त्र अपहरण करने का कारण प्रेत योनि में भोग रहा, बाद में क्या होगा, जन्म तो मिलेगा, सात जन्म गरीब रहेगा, भीख मंगा, और यदि ब्रह्मस्व अपहरण करे वो क्रिकोलास बनेगा, ये भी भागवत में है। एक दारोगा में एक ड्राई कुप में कोई क्रिकोलास वहां रहते थे, जदुवंशी और बालकों ने उनको उठाने के लिए कोशिश किया, उठा नहीं सका, तो बड़ा हल्ला मचा, हल्ला मचा तो कृष्ण जाकर अपना खब्बा हाथ से उसको पकड़ के उठा दिया। जब उठा दिया तब उन्होंने उद्धार होकर सुंदर देव मूर्ति एक प्रकाश, उनमें क्या है वो बता दिया। उन्होंने क्या किया, पुष्कर में यज्ञ किया था निगराज ने, उसमें से एक एक ब्राह्मण को एक एक लाख गोदान दिया, तो कोई गो वहां से लौट के दूसरी ग्रुप में आ गया और वो दूसरी ब्राह्मण को दिया, इससे उनका हो गया देवस्व, उनका पास गया, आप बताइए कि आप मुझको दिया कि उनको दिया, तो बोलता है इसका बदले में मैं एक लाख दे देता हूँ अलग, बोला गो के लिए आया नहीं, सत्य निर्णय करने के लिए आया, सत्य निर्णय करने के लिए, इन्होंने कुछ बोल नहीं सका, इसलिए उन्होंने क्रिकोलास हुआ। एक उद्धार कैसे होगा, जब साथ दिया तो उद्धार कैसे होगा, जब भगवान कृष्ण द्वापर युग में चाहेंगे उस वक्त उनका हाथ का स्पर्श होने से ये उद्धार। तो बाबा जी महाराज को बोला कि क्या करो, एक उद्धार करने के लिए मंदिर का पुजारी था, पैसा चोरी किया था, इसलिए हमारा प्रेत जो नहीं हुआ, बीज लगा हो गया। जब उनको पास रुपया दिया, बोला बाबा जी महाराज जैसे विधान नहीं करे, तो बोला इसमें वैष्णव सेवा करो, वैष्णव सेवा क्या है, गौ को करो सेवा, गौ को दिया और दो चार को नाम बताया, उनको चाहो जितना जो है, बोला ना ये धर्म ध्वजी है, इनसे कोई मंगल होगा नहीं, तब उसमें ऐसा उलगुल का आचरण, आंखों में दिखता नहीं ऐसा अभिनय किया। उस वक्त बड़ा थाली में उनको देता था भोजन, तब उसमें वही कुत्ता का बच्चा दो चार जाकर खाने लग जाता, तो सेवक ने उनको हटा दिया। तो बाबा जी महाराज गुस्सा किया, भोजन मैं नहीं करूंगा, ये वैष्णव को हटा दिया तुम, ऐसा अद्भुत चरित्र है, इसको ही समझेगा, ऐसा निंदा किया। बड़ा मुश्किल, रसिकानंद देव गोस्वामी उन्होंने किसी कारणवश जा नहीं सीखा जगन्नाथ जी को रथ यात्रा में। जगन्नाथ का रथ 6 बुनता था, अभी तो 3। वहां बीच में एक नदी था, उस नदी का से किश्ती में पार होकर के उधर 3 रथ दिया। रसिकानंद देव गोस्वामी जा नहीं सीखा, रास्ता में देर हुआ, बड़ा दुखी हुआ कि जगन्नाथ को दर्शन रथ में मिलेगा नहीं। अभी जगन्नाथ रथ वहाँ अटक कर दिया, उनका लिए काफी दिन तक वहाँ रथ रहा, काफी दिन तक रथ रहा। फिर उन्होंने किया, उन्होंने जाके रस्सी पकड़ा, तभी जगन्नाथ तैयार हुआ जाने का। इसलिए भक्तों प्रमाण करना किसी को मध्यम से नहीं, ये स्वयं प्रकाश ही होगा, जिसके जिसको जैसा है वो ऐसा ही ये करेगा। फिर हमने हमारा गुरुपाद पद्म का बारे में शिव अभी कुछ कहा था, अभी कुछ कहता कैसे, ये कभी भी अपना ये महिमा नहीं बोलते थे, उनका बारे में कुछ उनसे सुना नहीं, लेकिन उनका जो गुरु भाई है विशेष तौर पर श्रीधर देव गोस्वामी महाराज, ये लोग उनका मुख से यही निकल जाते थे। एक दफा वहाँ गया कोलेरगंज में, श्रीधर देव गोस्वामी महाराज का मठ में जाने में देर हुआ, यहाँ से किश्ती में जाता था, उनका तलाव का वहाँ उतारना और किश्ती वाला को वहीं रखना जब तक हम लुट के ना आए। वो जो ले जाता था उसका नाम था पटोल, जो किश्ती वाला नैया, और उनको लेके जाते थे। तो जब पहुंचा तब मधुसूदन गोस्वामी महाराज ने गुरु जी को बोला, हम लोग सब आपके लिए इंतजार कर रहा हूँ, आपको वहां से यहाँ आने में इतना देर हो गया, इतना देर हुआ। तो गुरुजी ने बोला, हमारा मठ में परिक्रमा में लोन हो गया, इसको किसका आगे किसका पीछे पेमेंट करना, ये हिसाब जुड़ने के लिए इनको जरूरत हुआ, तो इनको रखा था, तब इसलिए देर हुआ। जब देर हुआ तब उन्होंने ही करा, तब जाजावर महाराज बोला, क्या बोला, नारंभा नारवित कचित, ज्यादा आडंबर नहीं करना, और ज्यादा दुख उठाना नहीं। लोगों का चरित्र बताने के लिए इस इसको मैं बता रहा हूँ। उसी वक्त श्रीधरदेव गोस्वामी महाराज बोला, इसका उत्तर मैं देता हूँ। तब उन्होंने बोला, हाथी के लिए जो नस्सी होता है और दूसरे के लिए वो पर्वत चींटी के लिए, इसमें भी ये जो नारुम्भा नारोहित कचित ये रिलेटिव टर्म्स। इसका बाद उन्होंने यही बात बोला। क्या बात हुआ? जब हम लोग कुबूर में गया था गोदावरी का रामानंद का मिलन स्थल, उस स्थान पर जब गया प्रभुपाद ने पत्र लिखा, वहाँ चैतन्य पाद भी स्थापन करने के लिए कोशिश करना। पत्र गुरु जी से आदान प्रदान होता था, जब भी सुनिया सुनना से था, लेकिन चिट्ठी का आदान प्रदान गुरु जी से। तो उसने बात एक आदमी ने एक मुकाम देने के लिए इच्छा किया, लेकिन उनका जो वकील है वह कलंकर स्वामी, वो बोला ये लोग आया बंगाल से, कौन कह सकता है ये लोग एनार्किस्ट ना हो। तो इसमें एक लोकल कमेटी करके इसको दे देना। तो उसने ये बात जब प्रभुपाद को बोला चिट्ठी लेकर, तो उन्होंने टेलीग्राफ दिया, एक्सप्रेस टेलीग्राफ। जब आप लोग फर्दर प्रोसीड नहीं करना, महाप्रभु वहां पहुंचेंगे, जहां सब त्याग करके काय मौन जुबान से भगवान का सेवा का संपर्क लिया, वो लोगों का वो ये करेगा। वहाँ कलेक्टर को मिलने के लिए गया, जब कलेक्टर से मिला तो कलेक्टर बोला, मैं दर्शन शास्त्र 18 साल आलोचना किया, दर्शन महाचैतन्य देव का दर्शन प्रचार करने के लिए स्थान का क्या जरूरत है, कोई जरूरत नहीं। तब श्रीधर देव गोस्वामी उत्तर दिया, जो लोग काम का दास है इस दर्शन शास्त्र का एक लॉब्स समझ सकता है तो वो ही विरोध करने लगा, जैसे यहाँ गौड़ी मठ ना हो। अभी उस वक्त पूज्यपाद बंग महाराज जी वहां से चला गया, यहाँ होगा नहीं मद्रास। तब श्रीधर देव गोस्वामी महाराज गुरु जी से पूछा, प्रभु हमारा तो कई बार थोड़ा है, हम लोग कोशिश करके तो फेल हो गया, आपका क्या राय है? तो उन्होंने गुरु जी ने उत्तर दिया, हम लोग तो विशेष कोशिश किया नहीं, कोशिश करके तो देखो। तो जहां हम लोगों का कोशिश का शेष है, चरम है, एक्सट्रीम है, उनका शुरू ही हुआ नहीं, ऐसा दे दिया। उसका बाद वहाँ जमीन कलेक्शन किया, यहाँ उड़ीसा का एक सत्यवादी पंडा बहरमपुर का रहने वाले, तो उन्होंने वहाँ एक क्लार्क सर हेड क्लार्क, तो उन्होंने उनको बोला, चैतन्य देव 18 साल जगन्नाथपुरी में रहा, अरे पुरी से प्रेम धर्म प्रचार शुरू किया, तो आपका अब तो कुछ कर्तव्य है, आप क्या मदद कर सकता है? तो उन्होंने वही गुरु जी को साथ जाकर कलेक्शन किया, और वहाँ एक एंग्लो इंडियन का बागीचा था मौसम्बी का, वही खरीद किया। उस खरीद में करके वहाँ उस वक़्त मेला होता था, जिस वक़्त नासिक में पूर्ण कुंभ होता है, तब वही गोदावरी वहाँ भी यहाँ भी, तो वहाँ गोस्पोद कीर्तन में वहाँ भी एक मेला होता था, और गवर्नमेंट का तरफ से वहाँ मेला करेगा, तब वो उनको दे दिया। हमारा जमीन कोई रेंट लिया नहीं, लेकिन एक शर्त तो है, जो झोपड़ा बनाएगा वो झोपड़ा को तोड़ के ले जाएगा जी। ऐसा ही किया, और उसमें ही चैतन्य देव का ये स्थापित हुआ फल दे। बाद में तो वो सब साफ सुख करके महाप्रभु का विग्रह प्रतिष्ठा हुआ, तो उन्होंने ऐसा बोला, तो इसलिए उनका लिए ये नहीं है। इनके लिए वासुदेव प्रभु बोलते थे, सर्व घटे सब जगह में है। प्रभु बोला भवकानी नहीं, मेरा स्टेटमेंट है, इनका साथ कंपेयर कर जाएगा एकमात्र भक्तेश्वर पंडित का, जिन्होंने चैतन्य देव को कहा था, दस सहस्र गंधर्व मुनि देह चंद्रमुख तारा गाय मुई नाचो तबे मोर शोक, लगातार 72 घंटा नृत्य करते थे। ऐसा एक गुरुदेव के बारे में वहां बताया। तो ऐसा तो ये हुआ, और एक दफा गया, वहीं मैसेज करता हूँ, ये आप लोगों ने तो ये समझाएगी क्या वहां गया। उस वक्त पुरी में नित्यल्ला प्रविष्ट विष्णुवाद श्रीमद भक्त सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद का जो वर्क प्लेस, वही वर्क प्लेस को चिट्ठी लिखते थे गुरु जी, वो मिलने का संभावना हुआ। जब संभावना हुआ तब क्या हुआ, तो हम लोगों का पास तो 4 पैसा नहीं है, उस वक्त तो झोपड़ा में रहते थे, तो कौन देगा। तब कृष्णदास बाबा जी महाराज को चैतन्य मठ में भेजा, ये लोग ले ले, तो हम लोग जाके वहाँ दंडवत तो कर सकेंगे। उस वक्त मंदिर में जा, वो आप बास प्लेस में जाके दंडवत करने के लिए भी करियादार का पूरा परमिशन लेने पड़ता है, पार्टी जाएगा नहीं, 2-4 हज़ार नहीं जाएगा। अभी बाद में क्या हुआ, उन्होंने ना कर दिया। फिर गुरु जी गया बाग बाजार में, वहाँ उड़ोले में मान से मेला, तो मैं जेहेतु कनिष्ठ था इसलिए मैं नीचे रहा, और जगमोहन प्रभु गुरु महाराज ये ऊपर में जाके बात किया, और मैं वहाँ पाठ सुनने लगा। जो पाठ करते थे प्रभु का नाम था चिदानंद चिद विलास, प्रभुपाद का प्रदत्त नाम, तो उन्होंने वंदना करते हैं और वो गलती हो जाता, तो बाद में बोला आज वंदना नहीं करूँगा, हमारा पाठ में कोई बच्चा नहीं, क्यों मैं उचेष्टी कह लेंगे, मैं 7 बात बोल दूंगा। तो मैं वहाँ बैठा, बाद में वहाँ प्रसाद दिया, रास्ता में गुरु जी ने सब बोला, ये लोग भी बोला नहीं, क्या बोला, आपका पास स्वभाव गौड़ी मठ का दो नंबर कलेक्टर, तो बोला यदि विश्वास है तो लोन दीजिए। तो इसके बारे में भी कुछ कहा नहीं। तो गुरु जी ने बोला भागेर माँ गंगा पायना, ऐसा बोला। हम लोग कोई कोशिश करने पड़े। और जाजावर महाराज बोल दिया, क्या बोल दिया कोई वो लोगों का बीच में मधुसूदन महाराज, जाजावर महाराज और उनका नाम था दामोदर महाराज, परमहंस महाराज, श्रीधर देव उसमें नहीं महाराज, ये सब था वहाँ। उसमें बोला जाजावर महाराज, क्या बोला, माधव स्मरन्ति साधवस्तरे सर्गो कज्जीषु माधवम्। तब गुरुजी ने वही सब वैष्णव का साष्टांग दंडवत किया और बोला आप लोग जो ये किया तो मैंने कोशिश करूंगा। तो कोशिश करके प्रभुपाद का स्थान को उद्धार किया और मंदिर भी बनाया, संकीर्तन भवन भी बनाया। कलियादार था इसलिए जो मंदिर का है नक्शा था वो बन नहीं सकता उस वक्त, बाद में तो एक एक करके सबको हटाया। तो इसलिए गुरु जी ने मायापुर में मठ बनाया, इसी डिजाइन से ही वहाँ बनाया। और परमार्थ महाराज मुझको बोला जे चिट्ठी देख करके कोई होगा नहीं, उस वक्त जब मठ का प्रेसिडेंट था पंचवाद भक्ति वल्लभ तीर्थ महाराज, उन्होंने वो वहाँ एक किया वो भी कॉम्प्रोमाइज कर लेंगे, वो तो कॉम्प्रोमाइज नहीं किया जगमोहन प्रभु बोला। तो इसलिए मैं वो मामला किया 14 साल बाद में उसको पेंशन मिला। तो कॉम्प्रोमाइज करने जाएंगे तो पैसा भी बचा, आखिर में वो हो गया। अभी यही लास्ट 1 साल हुआ, अभी वो सब जो था उठा दिया, वहाँ हमारा मठ में ही ऐसा मोटरसाइकिल वगैरह मरम्मत करता था, सामान हमारा मठ में रहता था वहाँ। अभी उसको हाईकोर्ट करके, पहले हाईकोर्ट में जॉय किया था, दोबारा एक ही आज माफी की गुरु जी का इच्छा था इसलिए हो गया। जो मैं बोला इनको इन्होंने ट्रांसलेट करके बताएंगे तो समय लगेगा, इसलिए मैंने यहाँ से
Mother of people, this is new battery.
Srila Maharaj mentioned that how in the morning we have heard about Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, Srila Rasikananda Prabhu, as well as about Srila Bhakti Dait Madhav Goswami Maharaj. Because today is the disappearance day of all these three Vaishnavas. In the morning also, Maharaj spoke about three of them, and now also Srila Maharaj again spoke about three of them in a different way. Srila Maharaj mentioned in the very first thing that it is our duty to glorify the Vaishnavas all the time, especially on the appearance and disappearance day of Vaishnavas. By remembering them, we come across their teachings, their conduct, all these things, and which makes us understand very clearly that how to really follow the path of pure Vaishnavism. So in the morning, Srila Maharaj spoke about Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, that how he came to Srila Mayapur on the request of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur and declared the birth site of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Even though he was having advanced age, but still he jumped from his basket and started dancing and announced that, oh, this is the birthplace of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Manifested such a wonderful leela. And now Srila Maharaj mentioned that not only Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's birthplace, not only about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's birthplace, but he even indicated about Srivas Angan. He himself asked that, oh, how they have to measure the land, that which is the house of Shachi Mata and Jagannath Mishra, like the measurement of that house. And then where is Srivas Angan, how far it is. According to the measurement, he mentioned that, oh, this is the place of Srivas Angan. And then when they decided, afterward when they were digging that place for the foundation, then they found out one mridanga which was broken by Chand Kaji. The time when Srivas, in Srivas Angan, devotees used to perform kirtan, one time it happened that he sent somebody, Chand Kaji sent somebody, and they broke the mridanga. So in this way, Srila Maharaj mentioned that these devotees like Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, they are having Divya Netra, transcendental eyes. They are having this illusibility that they can see anything and everything of past, present and future. At the same time, they are having such a position that Dham itself manifests in front of them. Like Srila Maharaj mentioned, Dhamir Swarup Spuribe Nayane Haibo Radhar Dasi. Maharaj spoke about this particular line, Dhamir Swarup Spuribe Nayane. If we think that we will be able to see the pastime places of the Lord with our eyes, that is a misconception. We cannot see Dham with our eyes. Dham can manifest itself in front of sincere devotees. Sometimes Srila Maharaj mentions this verse, Sevon Mukhoi Jivado Swayamev Spuretata. Sri Krishna Namadi Na Bhavet Grajyam Indriyai. The name of the Lord, the qualities, the form, the pastimes, Dham, all these things are transcendental. And Atha Shri Krishna Namadi Na Bhavet Grajyam Indriyai. One cannot grasp them with their external senses. Sevan Mukhai Jivado. But when somebody approaches all these things with service attitude, with complete surrender, then by seeing the sincerity of a sadhak, these things, Nam, Leela, Dham, they manifest themselves in front of that sadhak. Then and only then he can see it. So Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, he was in such a higher position that Dham itself manifested all the time in front of him. That's why he was able to mention each and everything that was happening in Yogapeet. Sankirtan, Mahaprabhu is performing with all the devotees. And then where is Srivasangam, where is this place, that place? He mentioned all these places. He was having such a high position. He was on such a high position. Then Srila Maharaj mentioned another pastime, that how one time Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, when he was in Sridham Mayapur, his personal servant, Sri Bihari Das, he heard some sweet kirtan in the late evenings. And he asked Babaji Maharaj that, Babaji Maharaj, I want to go and listen that kirtan. Srila Babaji Maharaj mentioned that, oh, if you will go, you may be scared. He said, no, what is the, why? Kirtan is going on, I hear kirtan, but, and why I have to be fearful? Then Srila Babaji Maharaj said, okay, if you want to be fearful, it's okay, you can go. But if they serve some prasadam, don't take here. Give it to me, then and only then we will see what to do with that. And Bihari Das, he went for 3 nights continuously and used to bring prasadam from there and give to Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. After 3 days, Babaji Maharaj revealed that the prasadam which you are bringing, what is that? He showed him, and that even though when Bihari Das used to bring, that looked like some kind of sweet or savories or different things. But when Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, he took in his hand, immediately those things turns into nails and hairs and stool, all these things. So in this way, Babaji Maharaj showed him that, oh, what you have brought. And he was surprised to see what is this. And then Srila Babaji Maharaj mentioned him that the devotees or the people who are performing kirtan in the late evenings, who are they? They are ghostly people, ghostly persons. And then Bihari Das asked that how they can perform kirtan when they are ghostly person. Then Srila Babaji Maharaj mentioned that they are those kind of people, those who are known as those who became ghostly person because of Brahmasva Apaharan. Brahmasva Apaharan means, can say like, if earlier they were having, they were devotees, they were staying with the devotees, serving the deities, and then they did 2 activities. Apaharan means stealing. And they stole 2 things. One, those things which came for the Vaishnavas, and another things which came for the Lord. So, if can say like somebody gives something for a Vaishnava, that, oh, please take this thing and give it to the Vaishnava, and if you don't bring that thing to the Vaishnava and instead use it for yourself, then you are considered a person who is doing Brahmasva Apaharan, stealing that thing which is being meant for the devotees. So that's why there is a result of it. And what happens by Brahmasva Apaharan, that one becomes this Krikla.
Lizard?
Not lizard, but I think somebody can mention that when Krishna, he was in Dwarika, chameleon, then one becomes that. Why? Because chameleon means a living entity which changes the color time to time, wherever goes and makes color accordingly. So in the same way, a person, even though in front of devotees, like, oh, I'm your friend, I'm this, I'm that, and on their name, if he gets something, he uses for his own sense enjoyment and even pretends that I have not done it. That means again, showing so many different faces. So that's why he has to become chameleon. So that's why Srila Maharaj mentioned this whole pastime from Srimad Bhagavatam, that how one king, he donated so many cows to the Brahmins, but one cow, just by mistake, she got mixed again into those cows which he was going to give to another Brahmin. And then the Brahmin became angry with him. And finally, the result was that he became chameleon. And then he was again got this benediction also, that when Krishna will appear and he will touch your body, then and only then you will get delivered, not otherwise. Meanwhile, Srila Maharaj mentioned about Devasva Aparan also. This was Brahmasva Aparan, and another is Devasva Aparan. And what is that? Devasva Aparan means, can say like a person who is pujari, if something comes for the Lord, and if he is lusting on it, he wants to use it for himself, then that particular act is considered Devasva Aparan. And the result again is that a person has to become that kind of poor person for 7 lifetimes, that even though he may beg, but still he will not be able to get that much by which his stomach can even get filled. For 7 lifetimes he has to suffer if he performs Devasva Aparan. So in this way Srila Maharaj mentioned about Devasva Aparan, Brahmasva Aparan. So Srila Babaji Maharaj mentioned to Bihari Das that these ghostly people, they are in Vrindavan. Earlier they were pujaris, they were staying with the Vaishnavas, but stealing those things which meant for Vaishnavas or those things which meant for the Lord. That's why they are ghostly people now. And how they can get delivered? How they can get delivered? Then Srila Babaji Maharaj mentioned, unless and until they tell that what they have done, they can feel repentance in their heart, and whatever they had stolen, where they have kept, if they can tell and that can be used for the service of Vaishnavas, then and only then they can get delivered. And when this Babaji, Bihari Das Babaji, asked those people and they revealed it, and then those things which they stole, when it came, the property or wealth or whatever, it came in the hands of Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, he ordered that these things can get used in the service of Vaishnavas. Then and only then, these ghostly people will get delivered. And then Bihari Das asked that, oh, which Vaishnavas I should call? I can call all the Vaishnavas? He said, no. Most of them, they are Dharmadvaji. They are externally wearing the dress of a renounced person. But in reality, they are not renounced. That's why they are not Vaishnav. They are having kapatta in their heart. They are having duplicity. They are duplicious. So that's why he mentioned only 3 and 4 names altogether, even though there were many so-called devotees. They were there. But then he mentioned only 3 or 4 names. And mostly he said that give all the, like buy the eatables and bring it to the cows in the dham and give them. So in this way Srila Babaji Maharaj engaged Bihari Das for the service of cows and 3 or 4 people only. So in this way Srila Maharaj mentioned this was also a pastime of Babaji Maharaj, that how he was able to deliver all these people who offended earlier. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned another pastime about him, that even though he was manifesting a pastime where he was externally unable to see with his eyes because of his advanced age, when his servants, they used to give him prasad, at that time some puppies, they used to come and eat with him on the same plate. And Babaji Maharaj used to count how many are there every day. If by chance his servant, they forbid or some or other they chase the puppies away, then Babaji Maharaj would used to become angry that, oh, they are Vaishnavas. And mercifully they used to eat with me. why you are chasing them away. I will not eat if you will not bring them. So in this way, Babaji Maharaj was having such a personality that he was able to see a person beyond their bodies. Only bodies, like even though a person was having human body, he was acting as a so-called Vaishnava by dress even, but still Babaji Maharaj ignored and said they are not Vaishnavas, and on the other side accepting those who are having not even human body, taken birth in Dham, somehow or other they are in this body, Babaji Maharaj used to recognize them as Vaishnava. Such kind of extraordinary vision he was having, which ordinary people may not have at all. And then Srila Babaji Srila Maharaj again mentioned about Sri Rasikananda Prabhu. We heard this elephant story in the morning, and now Srila Maharaj mentioned one another pastime. That one time it happened so that Srila Rasikananda Prabhu, he was having a strong desire to attend Jagannath Rath Yatra, but he was unable to go for some reason. In those days, Jagannath Dev, for his chariot, there used to be like six chariot, because there used to be a river in between on the road, this grand road which we know where there is Rath Yatra now, because now only three Rath are there, three chariot are there. But in those days, six chariot used to be there. Because of river, they used to again shift the deities from one chariot to another chariot to come to Gundicha temple. So Srila Maharaj mentioned that even though he was having strong desire, because he was not there, so Lord Jagannath's chariot did not even move at all. And not only for one or two days, for many days, even though 100,000 people tried to move the chariot, but it was not moved. When Rasikanand Prabhu, he arrived in Jagannath Puri, he came near to the chariot and touched the rope. Then and only then, Rath started. Such kind of affection Lord Jagannath was having for his devotee, Rasikananda Prabhu. So Srila Maharaj mentioned that it is not that devotees, they want to, in the morning also he was mentioning, that devotees, they don't show their opulence, but somehow or other, Lord, he is having his plans that how he wants to manifest his devotees. In this way, Lord Jagannath, he revealed the glory of Sri Rasikananda Prabhu in this way. Then Srila Maharaj started speaking about his Guru Maharaj. In the morning, Srila Maharaj mentioned that I explained about one, I explained the glory of my Gurudev from one angle of vision. And which was that? That how he was always busy in serving the Vaishnavas. He always used to say, I have no other service in my life, I have no other goal in my life except serving the Vaishnavas. They are my worshipable objects. Does not matter how they behave with me, does not matter how they criticize me or whatever they speak about me, but the special quality which they have, they are having firm faith in the lotus feet of my Guru Padma Srila Prabhupada. That's why this only one qualification itself makes them my object of service. And in this way, he throughout his life, he served many, many Vaishnavas in different ways, whenever the need arises. Srila Maharaj mentions all these things in detail. In the morning also, he spoke some things about this. And now Srila Maharaj mentioned another angle of vision. Srila Maharaj mentioned that his Guru Maharaj, Srila Maharaj had an opportunity to stay close to his Guru Maharaj for almost 35 years directly, associating with him. And in those 35 years, Srila Maharaj mentioned, I never ever heard from his mouth anything what he has done. He never mentioned how he served Prabhupada, how he served his god brothers, and what kind of relationship he was having. He never ever used to speak anything about his glories. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned, the only things which we heard about him was mostly from his god brothers. that how he used to serve Srila Prabhupada and what kind of relationship he used to maintain with his god brothers. So he never ever spoke about himself at all. Srila Maharaj mentioned that I am going to mention one or two incidents only. The first incident Srila Maharaj mentioned that how Srila Bhakti Lakshak Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, who was his senior god brother, who was direct sannyasi from Srila Prabhupada, how he glorified his younger god brother Sri Bhakti Dait Madhav Goswami Maharaj. Srila Maharaj mentioned that one time it happened that actually for many years the devotees of Srila Prabhupada, after Gaur Purnima, on the day of Jagannath Mishra Mahotsav, they used to get together in Koler Ganjo, in Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj's Mathu, Chaitanya Saraswat Mathu. And they used to celebrate this Jagannath Mahotsav all together. One time it happened so, Srila Maharaj mentions everything in detail, that, oh, my Guru Maharaj, he was having one personal boatman. Then Maharaj even mentioned his name. That boatman was Patal. He used to bring him from here, Ganga Ghat, to Navdeep on the Ganga, which is very close to Kolera Ganju. So Srila Madhav Goswami Maharaj, he reached little late. And when his god brother Srila Bhakti Kamal Madhusudan Goswami Maharaj saw him, immediately he complained that, Maharaj, we are waiting for so long. All of us just waiting for you. Then Srila Madhav Goswami Maharaj, he said, please excuse me for that. But I was very, very busy because our parikrama just ended yesterday and I had so many things to manage, giving money to some people, asking them after some time we will pay this and that. So many things were there. So that's why I got late. And by hearing this, another god brother, Srila Bhakti Vichar Jajavar Goswami Maharaj, he mentioned that na ramba na rambit kvachit, means that why you have to perform that activity which takes lot of energy and maybe it is just a adambar. Adambar means something which you expand so much so that everybody can know that who am I? I am very powerful, I can do this, I can do that. So why you have to do that? You can just do little less exhibition, then what will happen? You will get more time. You will not be so busy. Then Srila Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Goswami Maharaj interrupted in between and mentioned that, Madhav Maharaj, you are not going to give answer for this. I want that I can give answer for this. And then Srila Madhav Goswami Maharaj mentioned, whatever you desire. Then Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj started mentioning to his god brothers that he is a person where all our endeavors came to end. He used to say that we have not even started yet. So such kind of energy he was having. Then he mentioned that a sugar cane for an elephant, it is like a snuff. Just like sugar canes are there, he can just take it. And for the ant, sugar cane is like a mountain. So in the same way, a particular activity, maybe for some of us, it may be like, oh, he's trying to show many things. But for him, it is nothing. Why? Because I have personally witnessed him in Kubur, on the bank of Godavari, when Srila Prabhupada sent Srila Bhakti Hriday Band Maharaj, myself, as well as Sri Haigri Brahmachari, means Srila Bhakti Dait Madhav Goswami Maharaj at that time. So we tried so much to acquire the land over there for Gaudiya Math, but we were unsuccessful. And Srila Bhakti Hriday Band Goswami Maharaj even left that place, that, oh, better I can go to Madras, it is not possible to acquire land here. And I was also trying But still, I was also unsuccessful. And I wrote a letter to Srila Prabhupada that there is a person who wants to give us land, but he is having a condition that some local people, they will be in the committee. Then Srila Prabhupada mentioned, don't proceed further. We are completely renounced for the service of Mahaprabhu. How come that we have to also stay under some of those people, those who are only sense enjoyers? So no need to like get that place in which some local committee is there. They will control us. We don't want to get controlled by them. And then Srila Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, he mentioned to Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj that, Prabhu, my name was, Prabhupada gave me name Ramanand Das. And this is the place of Rai Ramanand. He sent me here to acquire the land for some special reason. But I am feeling disheartened that I may not be able to do this task. Then Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj, but he mentioned to me at that time that, oh, we have not tried so much yet. It's just a beginning. Let us try a little bit more. So he said that at that time, after some time, we were able to acquire the land. And at that time, I realized why Srila Prabhupada calls him volcanic energy. Srila Prabhupada used to call Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj that he is a person who possesses volcanic energy. Why? Does not matter whatever service I will give him, without any question, he will come after accomplishing it. Before that, he will never come. That's why Srila Prabhupada used to call him volcanic energy. And Vasudev Prabhu means Sri Anant Vasudev. He used to call about him that Hayagriva Brahmachari is Sarva Ghate. Sarva Ghate means a person. You can send him for any kind of task. Sarva Ghate means he can accomplish anything and everything. It's not that he can only collect funds, he can only perform this seva or that seva. No. Whatever service is required, you just mention him. He will definitely accomplish it. And then Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj mentioned my statement about him. First was about Srila Prabhupada, what statement he made about Srila Madhava Maharaj. Then what Vasudev Prabhu used to tell him, and what is my statement about him, that he, I can only compare him with Vakreshwar Pandit, nobody else. Why? Vakreshwar Pandit was having such a volcanic energy that he can dance 72 hours without interruption. 72 hours he can dance completely and having no tiredness at all. So in the same way, I have seen him that how he used to serve Srila Prabhupada. How he used to get engaged and always enthusiastic, energetic. So that's why I can only compare him with Vakreshwar Pandit. So in this way, Srila Maharaj mentioned, in that assembly, I was able to hear this from Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. Even though I was staying with my Guru Maharaj for 25 years, but never ever heard this incident. But Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, when he spoke, then and only then, we heard that how he was serving. Then Srila Maharaj mentioned second incident because he spoke two things today only. The second incident Srila Maharaj mentioned that how when the time came that Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj heard that the birth site of Srila Prabhupada in Jagannath Puri, that is possible to get now. At that time he was having no funds in his hand, so that's why he sent his godbrother Srila Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj to Chaitanya Math, to Srila Bhakti Vilas Tirth Goswami Maharaj, that we can request him that he can buy that birth site now. But when Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj approached, at that time Srila Bhakti Vilas Tirth Goswami Maharaj, he mentioned that, oh, Srila Prabhupada never asked me to invest my energy for his birth site in Puri. He asked me only to take care of Srila Mayapur. So I am not going to make any endeavor for that. Then Srila Bhakti Dait Madhava Goswami Maharaj, he visited Bhakti Keval Odulami Maharaj, who was Acharya for Bagh Bazar branches at that time, the second division of Gaudiya Math, along with his godbrother Jagmohan Prabhu and took Srila Maharaj as his servant with him. So Srila Maharaj mentioned that how we went to Bagh Bazar Gaudiya Math. Guru Maharaj and Jagmohan Prabhu, both of them, they went to meet with Odulami Maharaj. But because Srila Maharaj mentioned, because I was young, so they did not took me with them. They said, oh, you just stay down, stay in the Natya Mandir. And I was sitting in the Natya Mandir. Then Srila Maharaj mentioned in Natya Mandir, what happened? That I was sitting and one disciple of Srila Prabhupada, whose name was Chidananda Chidvilas. Srila Maharaj remembered that. That how Chidananda Chidvilas, the disciple of Srila Prabhupada, he was going to speak Harikatha. But again and again, because of his age or for some reason, he was unable to chant invocation verses even properly. He was chanting half and then forgetting. Then again trying but forgetting. And finally he said that, oh, today I think I'm not going to chant these verses because I'm forgetting again and again. And then he started speaking Katha. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned what he spoke, that, oh, because I always speak truth. So that's why most of the people, they don't want to sit in my class. They are not there most of the time. So somehow Srila Maharaj heard his Harikatha downstairs, and upstairs they were having conversation, which Srila Maharaj heard from his Guru Maharaj in the car while coming back. What Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj mentioned, that, oh, even though we approached Odulami Maharaj, what he said, that, oh, I don't have so much fun that I can buy that land. But you are a big collector, second number collector of Gaudiya Math. So why don't, it is not difficult for you to buy this land, you can do it very easily. Then Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj said, though, if you believe that I am a biggest collector, then you can give us some loan. But still he did not reply. So then Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj is mentioning to his god brother Jagmohan Prabhu that there is one saying in Bengali, Bhager Ma Ganga Payana, means a mother who is having 5 or 6 sons, when she leaves her body, at that time her ashes, none of her son wants to bring to Ganga. Why? Everybody says that, why I have to spend money and energy to go to Haridwar and deliver these ashes to Ganga. Oh, this another brother can go, another brother can go. So all of them, they think like this and nobody goes. So in the same way, for this particular task, nobody is coming forward. I think I have to do something myself. So that's why, again, another year, they got together in Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj's mat. And then Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj mentioned this, that, oh, it is possible to buy that land, but I tried these, like, these are the two sections of Gaudiya Math now who are having all the properties, all the money in their hand, Chaitanya Math and Bagh Bazar, but both of them, they are not interested. So I think all of us should try to collect that place. Then everybody committed that, yes, they can give this much money, that much money. But that was very insignificant. Again, then Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj said, oh, we have to find out some other way. It is not possible to buy with this much money only. Then Srila Jajavar Goswami Maharaj, he quoted one verse. Madhavo, 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 Vachi. This verse is there. I think mostly we hear this verse after Yajna or after performing this Swasti Vachan, they speak this verse. Even though it is spoken about Lord Madhav, who is called Lakshmipati. Madhav means Lakshmipati. So, but he spoke that verse in context to Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj. That Madhavo, 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 Vachi. By remembering your name even, all the task is accomplished. If Madhav is there, means if Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj is there, then what is the need for anybody else to think about anything? He can do anything and everything by himself. Wherever he is, all auspiciousness is there. Whatever he wants to accomplish, he can accomplish. So when Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj heard this verse from his god brother, then immediately he paid his sashtang dandot pranam to all his god brothers. And then he mentioned that, oh, because you are giving me order that I can go forward for this task, and I am in full confidence now, even though I have nothing in my hand, but still I can accomplish this task because of all of your well wishes and mercy. So in this way, he marched forward for that particular project, and then after endeavoring a lot for it, he was able to acquire that land. So in this way, Srila Maharaj mentioned that this particular thing also he heard from Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, that how all these things happen. Even though Srila Maharaj was involved in some things in between, but everything he heard from Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. So in this way, Srila Maharaj mentioned that my Guru Maharaj, he was having such a personality that he never ever used to speak anything about himself. He always used to speak about the glories of Vaishnavas. Like we heard in the morning, that how he used to say that all my God brothers, they are so special, they are so so much dedicated to Srila Prabhupada, that they are my object of service. What to speak of you, all of you have to serve them. One time I was asking Srila Maharaj, that Maharaj, even though you served many disciples of Srila Prabhupada, but and they were also having very special conduct and everything, but still you must have some special feeling for your Gurudev, because he was your Gurudev and others are the God brothers of your Gurudev. Then Srila Maharaj mentioned that no, it never happened. My Guru Maharaj never ever left any scope for us to think that he is a little bit special than any other of his God brother. He never ever left that scope. Always he glorified his God brothers and always engaged in their service and engaged us in their service in such a way that I always in my heart naturally felt that how can I think that they are even on the equal level of my Gurudev, or to speak of lower than him. So each and every God brother, my Guru Maharaj used to speak about them in such a way, used to behave with them in such a way, and used to serve them in such a way, that always in our subconscious we were always having this feeling that they are all much more superior than our Guru. This kind of like seed has been sown in our heart from the beginning till the end of his life all the time. This was my conversation with Srila Maharaj, which he mentioned. So in this way, in nutshell, I think Srila Maharaj mentioned these two pastimes with other details also, but I think it's time is passing, so we just stop here. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.